All right, so we made it. We're all here. I think I was just informed that we might not be able to record, so I'm not going to be able to take the video in there with you guys, but I know I tried. Okay guys, we made it out. I'll tell you all about everything after I get in the car or at the house. I can sit down and tell you in confidence. So, our rides are here. All right, government business part is over for now. I guess we are touring the palace, which is right on the left of me. I guess back in the day, these waters were used to keep visitors from just coming over to the palace and taking over. Times have changed now. I guess things have gotten a lot more peaceful. We all focused on economics and not war, so they changed it up a little bit, but that's why that big river bank is there. So it's very nice out here. Yeah. The crew. Look how organized they are with cleaning the tree.
$3 US.
I'm sorry, 1868. Inferior family, moved from south of the year. And since then, it's a residence for Imperial family. Actually, Emperor and then.
All right, so we are in front of the palace. This is the palace. This is a lot of real estate in this palace. I mean,
they got security.
Gosh, just look at the real estate that's surrounding the palace. It's literally just one building in a 5 mile radius. At least 2-3 mile radius is one building. And then the city is the back road. There's security guards inside of these gates. As you can see, it's just standing there. And there's one and the other one as well. You think if I wave at him, he'll wave back? No, he didn't wave back. See, I'm not in the video because I'm recording. Hey y'all, look, they got my Ferrari. They delivering my Ferrari. Yeah. That's not my Ferrari. I really don't care about Ferrari like that, but I just want it to be funny. So we are leaving the palace now. I don't know where we're going next, but we're going on a trip in our favorite rocket ship, surfing through. All right, guys, So we are at a food court now. Not a food court, we're at a mall. This mall is called the Aqua Center. And it's actually really big. Like, that hallway goes all the way down there. Let's go to the top and work our way down. They have a Disney store. It's a lot of different Disney products. Yeah. I'm not really a Disney fan. I mean, I watch Disney movies, but that's not what I'm here for, because I can get Disney in the States. So this looks like a shop that has many, many different things. Let's check this out. Maybe I can get something for my Valentine, even though I don't have one. Is this a doggy shop? I think so. I don't know. Hourglass 700. A journal. For a journal. Yeah, they are definitely into Valentine. This is cool. Yoga stuff. Skateboard. I feel like it's just random, interesting things that somebody might find. Spontaneous gifts and items. Chopsticks. Candles. Sharks. And they have this eel. This eel is gonna go. I don't know if he's chasing a fish or another eel. Is there a sixth floor as well? Bro, how many floors does this mall have? And I mean, there's something on every floor, right? Bro. There's a seventh floor, bro. Wait, hold on. Because how many floors are there, bro? This is crazy. Oh, there's an eighth floor. All right, let's just take the elevator. Where's the elevator? Alright. I tried to go down to the elevator, but the elevators don't go up. But there's 9 floors. Please watch your step when you get off the escalator. So this is cool. This is a vibe, right? Got the whole Tokyo City. All right, you guys, there's so many different things to choose. They have dumplings here. And you know, when it comes to food for me, I don't eat meat, but I'll have an exception of fish. So I'm going to ask somebody here if they make dumplings without meat. And if they do, then I'm going to try it. And that was a no. They don't have dumplings without meat. That's okay. I gotta find somewhere I can eat. They got a Sizzlers here. Let's keep looking though. But look, I found the people who create funny characters. And looks like it's 2,000 yen. Try some shoes to go with my suit.
Smaller size.
Yeah, it's more appropriate than the big clunky shoes. My selection. I'm gonna go with these. Yeah. Bought some shoes in Japan. So it goes with the fit better than those shoes. It's cool. I like it. I like it. Alright, so got me a couple of things. I just realized they had Ghana milk chocolate underwear. That's very interesting, right? Ghana chocolate underwear, I've never seen that one. That's cool, okay. They got different flavors too. That's cool. Really spend time cleaning everything. Attention to detail is something they really prioritize. I mean, this place is different. Really makes me think about the big picture and grand scheme of things, where you find that countries have been destroyed, and when they rebuild, the rebuild is like way beyond its time. I don't really know. Don't take what I'm saying to heart. Take it with a grain of salt, but their mentality is so different here. All right, so I'm gonna work to find a tax-free counter. So I paid $6,500, and I guess if they were to take the tax off, I will only be paying $5,500. So it's fine. Here it goes. The tax station, I found it. All right, that was done. Some things are confidential, so I didn't really film the process, but pretty much an app that you download and you take a picture of your receipts, and after you do that, you enter in the amount, and then you choose what account that you want the things to be refunded into. So you choose either your bank account, choose a credit card, or if you have a PayPal account. And the company, the app, refunds the money and deposits it into your account. And it takes a few days, but seems more simple than tax refund. I don't know why tax refund is so complicated in the US. All right, so a lot of people ask me if Japan has advanced technology. My answer to that is actually not what you would think it is. The cash registers here are so advanced. It really speaks volume to how much they care about like community and just like, you know, when I sat in that meeting with the Minister of Foreign Affairs, he said that their focus is to make sure that the employees are happy and then the customers are happy. So the cash registers are designed in such a way that it's super efficient for the employees to use, almost as if they weren't there. But they're there because they have to manage it. But that being said, I paid 480 yen for my juice. And the lady, thank you, she poured the coins into the cash register. She didn't even count them. And the cash register like automated the transaction. So I just thought that was very amazing. So this is where we are now. We are at a farm. They're going to be farming. This is the setup. We're told that we can't film in the lab, so I'm trying to show you guys as much as possible before we go upstairs. And it seems that we have to take off our shoes and wear these special sandals as well. So I think this is probably gonna be one of the best learning experiences for me. So I'm really excited to be inspired today. And I'm going to take off my shoes now.
So this dress is called the Leaf Factory Tokyo. This is the vegetable factory.
このビルの中で野菜を育てて販売をしています。
So in this building, we grow vegetables and we sell.
So excited.
とてもワクワクしてます。で、まずはここのフロアの説明と、その後に実際にどのように育てられているかをご説明していきたいと思っています
。 So first of all, let me explain there, about this floor. After that, you can explore how there, we are growing vegetables.
こちらの図は、oh, we are growing.
So actually, we don't open our shop every day. It's not open. We don't fix our operation days.